Vanakkam, this is Haider Ali Sayyad from Asivagam, United Under Tamil Seva. Shaivism. After understanding Shaivism, I found one of the policy of Varna Dharam, that is rebirth of soul. Shaivism concept says, God, soul and bondage are three things that are eternal, that has neither beginning nor end. In previous video, we have explained how Lucifer, a creation, became Dark Lord, in other words, immortal. So, now let's conclude. God immortal, he is merciful. Soul too is immortal as it is God's particle. Person bondage is Lucifer, who was a creation which later was made into immortal, now known as Dark Lord. Fourth thing Shaivism philosophy talks about is rebirth of soul. Shaivism says that soul are many, so God gives them different body to soul to experience, as souls are ignorant. Remember, soul is particle of God. God is most knowledgeable. Atma knows Paramatma. Soul too is knowledgeable. Concept of rebirth is one of the Asivagam principle. Shaivism concept of rebirth of soul is corrected by Quran, which is an Asivagam reminder. How old is your DNA? Let's assume our age to be 40 years. Can we say our DNA is 40 years old? The answer would be no. This DNA, which is in our body, is given to us by our parents. So, our body age plus our parents' age is the age of our DNA. Am I right? Am I right? Again wrong. As your parents got their DNA, which is in you, from their parents. This way, if you keep adding, then you reach to the first DNA. Remember, before creation of the earth, human, God created DNA, the blueprint of life. So our DNA was there before the creation of the earth and human. Science says DNA is 4 lakhs years old approximately. So let's conclude. DNA which is in us is approximately 4 lakhs years old. Our DNA in us contains information of 4 lakhs years. Now coming to the concept of rebirth. Shaivism says rebirth of soul. That's not correct. Rebirth is there, but it's about our DNA. Quran and Asivagam reminder. Quran does not reject the concept of rebirth. Quran chapter 2 verse 28, it reminds about the concept of rebirth. I read. How can you disbelieve in Allah when you were lifeless and he brought you to life? Then he will cause you to die. Then he will bring you back to life, and then to him you will return. Yeah. Quran talks about DNA, the blueprint of life. Science too believes in rebirth of DNA. Scientific term of rebirth is replication of DNA. What came first, hen or egg? Yes, egg was created first. Therefore, before the creation of the earth, human, and from humus soil from earth, Allah created DNA of human. First DNA is like a blank cassette or CD, in other words, without any knowledge. Remember, DNA is ignorant, not soul. Soul knows creator, Atma knows Paramatma. Remember, we human are made up of three elements. First, humus, black soil from earth. Second, soul, a God's particle, Atma knows Paramatma. So soul is not ignorant. Third, DNA, the blueprint of life, which takes rebirth. Out of many rebirths, one single DNA sperms takes human form. Our body gets influenced by our ancestors' deeds. Our body gets influenced by soul whisper. And our body gets influenced by Satan whisper. Only way to eliminate Satan whisper and eliminate our past ancestors' deeds or karma is through meditation. Meditation helps the body to seek God's guidance through soul whisper. Plus, God made testimony with all humans who are going to be born till day of judgment. Quran chapter 7 verse 172 to 174, I read. And mention, when your Lord took from the children of Adam, from their loins, their descendants, and made them testify to themselves, saying to them, Am I not your Lord? They said, yes, we have testified. This least you should not say on the day of resurrection, indeed, we were of this unaware. Or least you say, it was only that our forefather associated with Allah. Therefore, we were not but descendants after them. that would you destroy us for what the falsifiers have done? And thus we do explain detail the verse, and perhaps they will return. They will return means part of spiritualism. So our DNA has made testimony with Allah, plus soul knows Paramatma. A soul is God's particle. It guides the body to become an image of God. If we activate Kundalini chakra by doing yoga meditation, so we can connect to our ancestors, plus we can get connected to higher conscious through meditation. Malam or dark energy has no influence on soul, as soul is aware of higher conscious, as soul itself is God's particle. Regarding dark energy, dark lord, in other words Satan Lucifer, he is immortal. His work to estray mankind from part of Asivagam, the religion of first Siddhar, Tamil Shiva. Shaivism believes in Brahmin's lie of rebirth of soul. So Asivagam believes in rebirth of DNA. Soul is pure. For pure soul, we make our DNA pure. Soul comes into mother's womb around 90 to 110 days. That's why Asivagam promotes the concept of Saptakani, Saptamuni. So our primary duty is to make our DNA pure, free from any negative elements. Satan's weapon is emotion and excitement. A child born out of mature seed, free from desire, emotion and excitement, that child would benefit the society. Brahmanism's strength is a concept of rebirth. Under rebirth concept, they run their business of fooling natives. They say, serve Brahman as they are due to moksha or salvation. They further say that one has to serve Brahman until the next life one are born in a Brahman's family. Under rebirth, native serving Brahmins hoping in next life they would be born in Brahmin's family from 5000 years. Rebirth of soul is one of the Varna Dharam principle. Asivagam agrees to the concept of rebirth, but that rebirth is about DNA. Scientific term is replication of DNA. Nandri, Vanakkam.